Hello, welcome to the Grow Daily podcast. I'm your host, Piyush Agarwal, and you are listening to the fourth episode of this daily podcast series. Thank you for hanging on. I see that some of you have started listening to my podcast daily. Thank you for that. That's a big boost to my morale, to my motivation to keep building, keep making these episodes. And if, in case you are new here, well, let me tell you what we do. We are going to talk about various aspects that will help us grow every day. Most of these aspects are going to be focused on your business, on your side gig, on your project. But at the same time, my hope is that by following some of these processes, this will also lead to a happier life for all of you. So without further ado, let's go ahead with this episode. So in the last two episodes, we spoke about the attitude towards failure and also how can you get started if you haven't yet. So if you are still on the edge, I would recommend you to listen to the last episode and make sure that you get started. In today's episode, let's push the bar a little higher. So what we are going to do in today's episode is talk about how can we organize our life better, organize our work better, organize it in a way that we feel more productive, feel more accomplished at the end of the day. And the trick behind doing that is to start making lists. Yes, get the power of list on your side and start organizing things that you need to do in a list. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if the first thought that came to your mind on hearing that is, why are we going to talk about list? Or you're already someone who uses list on a daily basis and finds them either very effective or has found them completely ineffective. Well, I'm hoping this episode will change some of those thoughts if you have found list ineffective. Personally, I am someone who is a lot more spontaneous when it comes to getting things done through a day. I would end up picking tasks as and when they come. I will also end up picking a lot of tasks that I have on my mind and getting them done through the day. But a lot of times I have seen or realized at the end of the day that the five things that I started the day with or the five things I thought that I will accomplish through the day at the start of the day, I still have about four of them left pending at the end of the day. And that generally is a big blow to my morale. If at the end of the day I feel that I was really busy the whole day, but I still don't feel that I have accomplished what I started the day with, it generally does not make one feel great, right? I don't know if you have been in the same position. And that's where lists come into picture. Now, if you're like me, you have definitely tried it multiple times and found it ineffective. But the best part about making lists and doing it is to be able to build and incorporate that habit. Also, what I have sort of realized over time is that there is an art when it comes to making lists. There is a certain science behind how you should approach your list. And a lot of times, most people fall into the pitfalls, make the mistakes, and end up finding lists completely ineffective. So in this episode, we will go over all those mistakes and ensure that you know how you can make better lists from tomorrow. But before we dive into that, you still may be wondering, why are we talking about lists? Now, like we talked about in the last episode of Getting Started, it's very important that you make a note of why you are doing something and what is required for you to get started. These are basic bullet points, but both those bullet points, each of them are basically a task each, and those tasks just help you get more clarity in a very short amount of time. These lists are nothing more than that. Now, the kind of lists we are talking about here are more like action lists. These are sort of the to-do lists that you have heard of, and you basically, every morning or at the end of every day, I would recommend you sit down, you write down the list of tasks that you need to accomplish, that you need to finish. Also, if you have a personal method, mention what's the kind of urgency. Sort of prioritize them in a way that you put the most important task at the top and the least important task at the bottom. And this is really key of making effective lists, making lists which really do the job, which really make you feel that you have accomplished something at the end of the day. You should always put the most important and the most difficult task at the top of the list. And make sure you do that first. Don't skip the first few items and move to the one that you find the easiest. Now, this is the biggest pitfall for most of the people who have found lists ineffective, including myself. What I end up doing is I will end up writing all the things that are on my mind, you know, get them all from my mind, on the paper. And of the 2022 things that I have mentioned on the paper and things I have to do, suddenly when I look at the list, it feels like, oh my God, there's so many things that I need to accomplish. What I'll do generally next is, of those 2022 things, I will start to identify what do I have to accomplish on that day. So make a day-wise list. Make a list that is specific to that day, and only those things should be mentioned on that list. Remove everything else which is not important, which is not urgent, which is not something that you need to do on that day from that list of yours. Now, even in that day-wise list, make sure that you prioritize the list in a way that your most important task comes right at the top. We as human beings have a tendency of always picking the easiest task first. You know, the task that's most familiar, the task that we know that we already have all the steps in place. We trick our minds by telling, hey, this will only take 5 minutes, so let me take care of this first, and then I can move to that task which will take me a couple of hours. But that is a sandpit. That is a sandpit because we will end up picking similar tasks that we are already very familiar with, and we will keep checking them off the list and feeling that we have done so much, you know, we have completed so many tasks in a very short span of time. So maybe now I deserve a break. We'll go on Facebook, we will check those tweets, we will make sure we watch a YouTube video, or maybe even get up, go take a coffee break, have a nap, and come back feeling like, oh yeah, I deserve it because I have already completed so many tasks. And that's how you start sinking in your own tasks, right? So instead, what you need to really tell yourself is that we need to complete the most difficult task first. There's a phrase which is popular in the productivity circles. It's called eat the frog. Now, eat the frog, if you think about it, it's disgusting, right? The whole thought of eating a frog is disgusting, although a lot of communities eat it. But the whole idea behind the phrase is not to make you really eat the frog, but make sure that you pick the most difficult task, the most disgusting task, the task that you have been running away from for a while first, and complete that at the start of the day. Now, why would you do that? Why would you start your day with a task which you really don't feel like doing, which you really find difficult, which you really rather just give it to somebody else and completely get rid of? The idea is that when you complete the most difficult task at the start of the day, you feel extremely accomplished and you feel that you have already achieved so much in a very short span of time, and you have so much more that you can achieve in the rest of the day. So you feel motivated, you feel completely up to any task that's thrown at you, and most importantly, you have gotten rid of something that you have been avoiding for a while. So eat the frog early in the day. Make sure that's the first task that you do, and the first task is always the most important one, right? And the most difficult one. Now, there's another reason why we do this. When we are doing a lot of easy tasks, just because of the sheer number of checks that we are making on our list, we feel that we are doing a lot of work, or we have done a lot of work. But in entirety, if you look at the amount of time you have spent, that will be very low. Or what kind of impact those tasks are driving, that may also be really low. So what happens is, by completing those tasks, we feel like we need to reward ourselves because we have done so much work, and we end up taking naps, we end up taking breaks, we end up doing things which would rather just eat up time and make us more lethargic. On the other hand, when we do the most difficult task at the start of the day, we are basically ensuring that our mind is super active. At the end of completing the task, you actually don't feel like taking a break. You feel like doing more. You are motivated, you are completely excited about your day, and you want to make sure that you get more and more done. And that's the idea of creating an effective list. An effective list is not about making you feel that you have done a lot of work in a day, or making you feel like you have checked so many different things in a day, so the day was productive. It's more about making your mind, tricking your mind to think that once you have completed a task, there is more to be done and it can do a lot more. And that's how our body works as well. We are the ones who tell our bodies that, you know, we cannot run that 5 mile, or we cannot participate in the chicken wings eating competition because, you know, we don't have an appetite. Well, actually, our body is very malleable. Our mind is completely mold worthy. We can mold it, we can make it work, we can make it believe anything that we want. So if you want your mind to be working faster to get more things done, you can make it do that. If you want to, your body to be able to run and not get tired or figure out how you can complete that 5 mile run, you can do it. Obviously, you cannot just get up one day with no practice, with no preparation and just run a 5 mile. You may be able to complete it, but that's the kind of exertion that you don't want to put your body through. On the other hand, if you plan it with the right kind of list, if you plan it with the right kind of rewards, you will see that your body is transforming and you're able to get more done. You're able to do more. You're able to achieve more every day, right? So avoid the popular list making mistake of putting the easy task on the top, completing the easy task first, and then worrying about the most difficult one. Create your list on a priority basis. Make sure your list has only the things that you need to do on that particular day and remove all the rubbish out, right? Now, you may be asking, after listening to all this, list making is great, Piyush, but tell me what's the best way that I can make lists? You may not like it, but the best way still stands to be a physical notebook and a pen or a pencil, you know. There's a different feeling when it comes to writing your list down with your pen. When you're writing it down, it's almost like you're committing to getting it done on that day. Obviously, with smartphones now, there are so many different ways that we can make lists that you may not really feel the need to have a separate notebook and carry a pen as well. And that's fine. Use the method that works for you the best. I have seen that a physical paper, notebook, or a pen works the best for most people because there's a different joy in able to physically strike out one of the items. It really feels like you have accomplished that, you have completed that. But in case you are into more of an application or you would like to get better ways of doing it on your phone or online, there are a plethora of tools available when it comes to creating to-do list. Just one word of caution that a lot of those tools, especially the mobile apps, are not very effective because they are not really as smart as they claim to be. What I find effective is are applications which provide me enough flexibility when it comes to creating lists and which provide me some sort of a smart way of organizing, of realigning my goals. If there are some things that I have not accomplished on a day, I should be easily able to push on the other side. There are two different apps that I use for this purpose. One is Evernote. Now, if you have heard of Evernote, you know that it's a notes-taking app, and that's what the primary goal is behind designing the app. But trust me, Evernote is a popular and a very powerful app which can help you do and achieve a lot more. It comes with so many different templates. It comes with a checklist that will allow you to create a list in minutes, and you can actually check things off and get them off your list. There's another tool which is not exactly a to-do list tool, but it's more of a bullet-based listing app which helps me make sure that I'm only focusing at the task at hand right now or the day at hand. Is Workflowy. Yes, you heard me right. Workflowy. It's a very simple online tool. You cannot really download it, but you can just create an account, log in, and start creating lists. It works on the idea of that you can expand bullet lists, create nested bullet lists, and make sure that when you're looking at a bullet list, you can just have your focus on that one bullet list and not go to all the lists. So you can create a week worth of plan in Workflowy and still have only that day's plan available to you so that there's nothing else distracting to you. Apart from that, obviously, like I said, there are apps like Todoist, there is an app called Taskful. These are different mobile apps that are available that will help you complete the task. So there's no specific tool that I would say that you need to use in order to complete your list, in order to check things off your list. Whatever you find helpful, whatever you find handy, you should be able to use that. I have already listed three. Try these three out. If you feel that there's something still missing, as and more that you use lists, you'll realize that there are specific aspects that you would like to have more control on. There are specific aspects, there are specific ways that you work around lists that these apps do not provide enough flexibility with. Feel free to opt for something else. Feel free to choose something else and find the right app that works for you. Because growing every day, it's all about experimentation. So why wouldn't you experiment and find the tool that works for you the best? And on that note, we have come to the end of this episode. I hope you found this episode helpful. I will be leaving out links to the tools that we spoke about in the description of this podcast episode, and I hope you will get to try them and share your experience. If you're already expert at making lists, if you already have tools and techniques that you use that you would like to share with me and the community, please feel free to do that. You can just drop me a note at hello@piyushagarwal.com or the soon-to-be-done website growdaily.xyz. On that note, I would like to say goodbye. Please do share your thoughts and comments. I would love to know if these series are working for you. We will dive more into list making in the next episode as well on how you can make smarter and better lists. But until then, goodbye. You have been listening to the Grow Daily podcast, and this was your host, Piyush Agarwal. Thank you so much for tuning in.